guys. So I try to do a video on the ACCA for you every week, and I've realized that I've done many, many technical videos, but I've not really done a video on a career path. Now, you know that I think that the ACCA is your passport to doing whatever you want to do in the future. I think it is an absolutely fantastic foundation. However, how do you choose what you want to do in the future? You know, from my past videos, I have jumped a bunch of careers. My goodness, it took me a long time to fall into one where I actually fit. And I was thinking today that if I had done my ACCA previously at the start, I'm not working in a professional job, so how would I have figured out that this is what I wanted to do, that I wanted to teach? Well, I think that what I would tell my kids when I make them do the ACCA is I would ask them, first of all, to make a list of the things that they are good at. And the second thing that I would ask them to do is I would ask them to make a list of the things that they enjoyed most from the things that they were good at, and try to make that into a profession. Because that's what I feel. Now, let me give you me as a personal example. I'm not gonna give you all of the things that I'm good at. I hope that I'm good at a lot of things, which I'm that kind of personality. If I put my head to something, I will be good at it. But I'm gonna give you the things that I was good at that I enjoyed most. I enjoyed studying. You guys know that. I love studying. I enjoyed communicating and interacting with people. I enjoyed my language. I'm lingual. You know that I speak 3 or 4 languages. And I was the type of personality, and I like being this type of personality, that my follow-up until something was done was really, really strong, okay? But these are the things that I was good at that I enjoyed most. Now, I took these things, and what did I do? I made it teaching, which I think anybody can do if they make these 2 lists. I was good at studying, so I knew my work. I could convey it to somebody well because my communication and my language was good. And students are lazy, right? We all know that. So my follow-up worked for me in this aspect. So if you are at a point in your life where you're doing something, you're doing your ACCA, but eventually in the future, you don't know. Do you want to have a business? Do you want to be in a corporate job? Do you want to do something else? I would really suggest that you make these 2 lists and create a profession out of it. I'm sure it's possible. I wish that I had this advice when I was younger. I probably would have started when I was way younger and made more money. But yeah, and I do feel that our decisions with regards to our career paths are very imprinted by our parents. My parents have jewelry stores and construction industries, and my mom was all about me being a self-made woman and having a jewelry store of my own. But I've worked in a jewelry store for many years, but I could never be a salesperson. I just never believed in what I actually sold, so I couldn't really sell it. And that was really stressful because my parents were so fantastic at it. So I do think that you should choose a career out of these 2 lists. And I do think that you need to look at both aspects. Financially, yes, you have to sustain from your family. For your family, you have to sustain. But if you don't have a certain level of satisfaction from what you're doing, even if you're financially sustaining, you're not going to be doing that for very long. These 2 go hand in hand, and you need to find a balance between them. So this is my little input on if you are doing the ACCA and you're not sure what you want to do after, what you can do to help you decide. If you guys like the video, please like, please share, please subscribe, and comment if you want any other advice.